Good afternoon all. This is Dr. Mahesh M. Wanjiri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SBM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. I welcome you all to today's online class in the subject Supply Chain Management conducted for MBA Semester 4 students. So today we are going to learn from Unit 5, Chapter Number 9, Sales and Operations Planning in a Supply Chain. Okay, so I repeat, sales and operations planning in a supply chain. Okay. So what we are going to learn today basically is how a company responds to predictable variability in a supply chain. I'll explain later what is predictable variability. So the chapter discussion revolves around managing this predictable variability itself. Then related to predictable variability, how a company manages its supply as well as its demand. So it's a small topic which we are going to complete today. Okay. Now, before I begin the class, so a little bit of background. So one is sales department basically deals with demand forecasting, and operations or production department deals with supply related aspects. So there should be coordination between the sales as well as production or operations, okay, so that the demand forecasting accuracy can be achieved. As the accuracy of the demand forecasting increases, the supply chain costs decrease and profitability increases. Now coming to predictable variability. Variability means change. Predictable variability is that part of the change in demand which can be predicted or estimated with fair accuracy. This is applicable to products which have a seasonal demand. Okay, so with this background, we are going to make a beginning to this chapter. Okay, so responding to predictable variability in a supply chain. So first, what is predictable variability? Predictable variability is change in demand that can be forecasted. Say for example, okay, soft drinks, okay, or ice creams. So the major season for these products is summer. So every year the company makes most of its sales during summer season. So during other seasons like monsoon and winter, the sales will be lower. So during summer, the demand for soft drinks and ice cream increases. So we say the demand is a peak during summer for ice creams and soft drinks. Okay. So I hope you are able to understand. Similarly, the demand for pesticides, fertilizers, especially pesticides, fertilizers and seeds. The demand for fertilizers and seeds is basically high at the time of cultivation, which happens in India generally between May to June. So I hope I'm right. Okay, so every year the company knows what will be the increase in demand during the season. Accordingly, the company manages its supply and demand. That is what we are going to learn today. So this predictable variability can cause increased costs and a decreased responsiveness in the supply chain. That is the reason why a company tries to manage this predictable variability or respond to this predictable variability. Variability is the change in demand. Okay, predictable variability means the change in demand that can be forecasted. Okay, so the companies whose products are seasonal, means during the season they see the peak period, means highest demand, and during non-peak period the demand will be low. So for such companies face the problem of increased cost, okay, during the season or during the peak period, and decreased responsiveness in the supply chain. As the demand increases during the peak, the company has to arrange for manufacturing of additional number of units. That is how the cost increases. And since the number of orders will be very high, the responsiveness also decreases in the supply chain. That is the reason why a company needs to handle this predictable variability efficiently so that the supply chain cost can be controlled and the responsiveness can be maintained in the supply chain. So how does a company basically handle or manage predictable variability in? So using two broad approaches. So one is managing supply side and the another is by managing demand side. Yeah. So as I said, the supply side and the demand side, the supply side is taken care by operation side, production side, because the production or operations department is responsible for procuring raw materials, converting the raw materials into finished goods, that is manufacturing, okay, using the production capacity and holding finished goods inventory and meet the customer orders. And demand management is considered by sales department, as a sales does the forecasting for demand for its company products. So let us understand these approaches. Manage supply. So how a company tries to handle predictable variability. Manage supply using capacity. Okay, so capacity, when we say, we are talking about production capacity. So by having a flexible production capacity, like manufacture in lower quantity during non-peak and manufacture in larger quantities during peak period. So by having such a flexible production capacity, a company can manage to decrease costs. Inventory. Okay, so a company can manage the supply side by holding lower level of inventory and or subcontracting. Okay, the company can, whatever the additional demand that is going to arise during the peak period, that additional demand, manufacturing of additional products can be subcontracted to another company. Okay, and the company can also manage supply using the backlogs. Backlogs are the customer orders which have not yet met by the company. Okay, so by producing enough and meeting the backlog orders, the company will be able to manage supply side. We'll learn more about how the company manages supply side in next slide. And managing demand. Okay, the company can use short-term price discount and trade promotions to shift some part of the demand from peak period to non-peak period. Okay, say for example, it is not applicable to all types of products, it is not general. Say for example, in case of fertilizers and seeds, if the major season is of purchase of pesticides and fertilizers and seeds is the May to June, and during which the demand is going to increase, and the company will struggle to manufacture the additional units and to meet the demand. So they can shift some part of the demand from May, June to March, April. How they can do it? They can sell the seeds and fertilizers on price discounts, or they can give some trade promotions. Not entirely, but some percentage of the demand from May, June will shift to March and April. And company will be relatively comfortable during the peak period. Okay, so anyway, again, how the company manages demand side also will be discussed in next slide in detail. Okay, so now we'll go ahead and let us learn to handle predictable variability. So I repeat, predictable variability is change in demand which can be estimated or forecasted. And I also explained, so variability here means change in demand. Okay, so exactly or specifically what are we considering is, when we say change in demand, increase in demand. So I repeat, so when you talk about change in demand, we are talking about increase in demand. So during season, as I explained a simple example for ice creams and soft drinks, the demand for ice creams and soft drinks increases in summer. Okay, that is the peak period for ice creams and soft drinks. So other than the normal sales for the remaining 8 months, what is the additional sales during summer? That additional sales every year it happens. So the company is in a position to forecast that increase in demand during seasons. That is what we call it predictable variability, or the change in demand or the increase in demand which can be estimated by the company. So since the demand increases during season, okay, costs increase and responsiveness decreases. So that is why we are going to learn how a company handles predictable variability by managing supply and demand. So I hope you are on a common platform now. So now let us first see and learn how a company handles predictable variability, okay, by way of managing supply. So in managing supply, the company can either manage capacity, when I say production capacity, or the company can manage inventory, or both. So how a company can manage production capacity? Capacity here is production capacity. So to keep the costs lower during peak period, okay, during the season in which the demand will be highest. So one method is the time of flexibility from workforce. So here we are talking about overtime. Okay. So the same employees who are working in the factory can be asked to work overtime. Okay. So instead of 8 hours, they can work for, okay, 12 hours, for example. So this time flexibility from workforce, using the same number of employees, but making them to work for more number of hours, our company can make use of, okay, maximum production capacity and produce more number of units during the peak period without any additional, okay, increase in cost. So same factory, same workforce, only thing the workforce will be asked to work overtime, O-V-E-R, overtime. Okay, so that is one way how a company can manage its production capacity by way of time flexibility from workforce by asking them to work overtime. Okay, so I gave an example. Generally, the shift will be of 8 hours and the same employees can be asked to work for 12 hours. Okay, so to that extent, these workforce will produce extra number of units or manufacture additional number of units to meet the increased demand during the peak period. Second method is use of seasonal workforce. See, there are some businesses, okay, so that basically have very high demand or peak, okay, demand during season. So tourism is one very good example. So if you consider Goa, okay, which is one of the popular tourist destinations, okay, tourists all over world visit Goa. Okay, but basically if you look at the season, okay, so it starts from November. Okay, so the tourist starts coming in November, December, January, February, March, April, May. Okay, so basically these 6 months are the main season for tourism industry in Goa. That is again from November the demand starts increasing. November, throughout November, December, December last week and January first week, the demand will be peak. Okay, for hotels, okay, and the restaurants, okay, the demand will be peak at restaurants and hotels, as well as for travel industry, transportation. Okay, and after January, from February, the demand starts declining. Okay, so basically December last week and January first week are the peak period for tourism in Goa. Okay, and the remaining 6 months, like from June, okay, they usually consider it as off season, and even many hotels and resorts offer discounts on bookings as well. So in such a case, okay, so what the hotels can do basically is they use seasonal workforce. So here we are not talking about, okay, here we are not talking about the same employees working extra time. When you say time flexibility from workforce, we are talking about same employees of the company working extra hours. Here, the company can use seasonal workers. It means the hotels, resorts can, okay, recruit, okay, new employees only during the season, who will work only during the season, and after the season, they will be laid off. So we are talking about that seasonal workforce. But this strategy works only where the labor market is very good and flexible. if the labor market is very tight, means availability of the seasonal workforce or part-time workers are difficult, then this strategy will not be possible. So companies during season hire additional workforce, okay, and this workforce will work only during the season when the demand will be peak. Okay, so one more method I learned in Goa from five star hotels. So one of the five star hotels, Hotel Ramada, I visited in Warka Beach. Okay, so or around. Okay, so what they mentioned is for 6 months, okay, that is from June to October. Okay, so June, July, August, September, October. Okay, so including considering, let us say, November. Okay, about most of the hotel staff is sent back to home. Most of the hotel staff is sent back to home and they are paid only half salary. They are not removed from job, but they are paid only half salary. Okay. And the same workforce is employed during the season for next 6 months. And during the season, these employees are paid full month salary. So this is one more unique way to manage capacity, to handle predictable variability in demand. And the third method or third way of handling predictable variability in demand is use of subcontracting. So here the company can keep manufacturing the same number of units every month, say for example, but only during the peak period, during the season, whatever additional demand arises, the company subcontracts manufacturing of its products to another company, so that the company can maintain its level of production capacity, and thus maintain its costs. But again, here when the company wants to subcontract, so when a company wants to subcontract manufacturing of its products to another company, they need to consider the company to which subcontracting is given, means the company will request another company on its behalf to manufacture its products. So that is called subcontracting. So the subcontracting company should be flexible enough. Flexible, when we say, it should be able to handle the increase in demand or the incoming order from the company. Second, to keep the costs lower, so this subcontracting company should be aggregating the orders. Aggregation of orders means, other company should also be giving, the subcontracting orders to the same company. So where maximum production capacity is utilized and economies of scales are achieved and fixed costs are maintained at a lower level. And one more feature of the subcontracting company should be, variety of the products. So the subcontracting company should be in a position to manufacture a variety of products, keep coming from where different customers are ordering. So in the absence of a flexible company like this, it will be difficult for a company to subcontract manufacturing to an outside firm. So this is about how a company manages or how a company handles predictable variability, means how a company meets the increase in demand during season using its production capacity. I will take questions from you after this. Then one more way is by managing inventory. So a company can handle increase in demand during the season, by way of managing inventory by the following ways. One is using common components across multiple products. Say for example, the demand for consumer electronics is also seasonal in our country. The demand for automobiles is also seasonal. Most of the sales happen during Deepavali festival. The demand during Diwali festival, that is October and November, the demand will be very high, very peak. So one example what I can give you here using common components across multiple products is, if you are aware about passenger automobile brand called Fiat cars. So though we know the Fiat car share in Indian market is very low, but how actually this company makes more money? So for those who are not aware, Fiat company basically makes engines, car engines. Okay, and most of this, okay, these same car engines are installed in different models of cars. Okay, for example, in case of Maruti, Maruti Suzuki India Limited. Okay, the cars like SX4, Vistara, Ciaz, Brezza. Okay, so as well as two more models of Maruti Suzuki cars are there, in which the Fiat engines are installed. Similarly, Fiat supplies the same car engines to many companies. So when you consider the demand for, okay, Brezza, Vistara, S4, SX4, okay, the demand will be different, but the demand for the Fiat engine will remain more constant, okay, or more stable. So by this way, using common component across multiple products, a company can have a more accurate demand forecasting. And when a company obtains a more accurate demand forecasting, it can maintain a lower level of inventory. It can maintain a lower level of inventory, and that is how a company can meet the increase in demand without increasing inventory levels by using common component across multiple products. It is also same, okay, in case of mobile phone manufacturers. If you come across most of the mobile phone components, okay, in different models, they are quite common. So this is about maintaining lower level of inventory by way of using common component across multiple products. Now, second way to handle increase in demand or predictable variability is by building inventory of high demand or predictable demand products. So what a company can do in this case is, okay, the company can build, okay, a large amount of inventory. The company can manufacture, 1 minute. Okay. See here in this case, for example, so if we consider a company which is manufacturing jackets, I repeat, if we consider a company which is manufacturing jackets, okay. So the same company, the company selling jackets to defense, let us say army department, police department as well. So these are business customers, okay, and the demand is stable from these business customers. Every year they give more or less same quantity of order for jackets. And let us say the jacket manufacturing company also sells through retail stores, okay, from where consumer market, okay, is supplied. So in the consumer market, customers like me and you, we go to the retail store and purchase the jackets. So here what happens basically is the demand for jackets in the consumer market is highly unpredictable. Okay, but the demand for jackets from army and police department is fairly predictable because it is a contract, and the more or less the same number of jackets the government departments are going to order. So what a company can do is the company can manufacture, okay, the consumer market jackets, the jackets which will be sold to customers like me and you. So these jackets can be manufactured during off season. Since there is no perishable, so since jackets are non-perishable in nature, the company can manufacture jackets during non-peak period or during off season and make use of production capacity and build a large level of inventory for, okay, build a large level of inventory for police and army department jackets because the demand is more assured, the demand is more predictable and stable. And the company can manufacture, okay, the jacket for consumer markets near to winter season. Okay, so almost close to winter season where the demand forecasting will have higher accuracy due to the, okay, decreased timing. So this is how, one way by building a lower inventory or another way by building a higher inventory, okay, a company tries to handle predictable variability in demand. Okay, now one more slide and after this I will take your questions. Inventory or capacity. Okay, inventory or capacity trade-off. So as I said, either the company can make use of production capacity strategies or inventory strategies to handle the increase in demand or to handle the predictable variability in demand. So what is the trade-off a company has to make between inventory and capacity? Capacity is the production capacity. Leveling capacity forces inventory to build up in anticipation of a seasonal variation in demand. Okay. So if a company levels its capacity, production capacity, means it manufactures exactly the same number of units throughout the season, means throughout the year, means even during non-peak or even during off-season, the company continues to manufacture goods, towards the season. Thus, it builds a inventory. In anticipation of seasonal variation in demand. Okay, so that is one method. Okay, but the inventory is built up far ahead of the actual demand from the customer. Say for example, winter season, the jackets for winter season are manufactured in, let us say, summer and monsoon itself. Okay, that is one example. Or carrying low levels. So this is the inventory. Company builds a higher level of inventory by continue to produce even during non-peak periods or during off-season. The other method is, so inventory will build very high. Two disadvantages of this is, one, inventory carrying cost will be very high. And second, the goods are produced far ahead of the actual demand. And the demand forecasting accuracy will not be very high. Carrying low levels of inventory requires capacity to vary with seasonal variation. Means the production capacity should be highly flexible. So we have already discussed how production capacity can be made flexible by way of having time flexibility from workforce or use of seasonal workforce or by way of using subcontracting. Okay, so carrying a company can carry low level of inventory. Okay. But it requires capacity to vary with seasonal variation in demand by way of having flexible capacity or enough capacity. The company can have excess production capacity so that during the peak demand, the company can the company itself can manufacture the additional goods and supply to the market. But if the company has additional production capacity, so only that maximum capacity can be utilized only during the season, and during off season, the maximum capacity of the production will not be utilized, hence, but fixed cost are going to remain same. Hence, the overall cost will be again higher. So, what level of inventory and what level of production capacity has to be decided is a $1 million question. That is what we call inventory capacity trade-off. Okay. So, 1 minute. Okay. So I think one more slide is remaining and I have 7 minutes. So I'll go ahead with this. Then I'll take questions from your end. So the other part, the way we learned, if you can remember, a firm can handle increase in demand during season, or a firm can handle predictable variability using two broad approaches. One is by managing supply and another is by way of managing demand. So by way of managing supply, we learned how a company tries to handle predictable variability in demand. And the second way or approach to manage predictable variability in demand is by way of managing demand. So let us see how a company tries to manage demand to handle predictable variability. So one way is promotion or pricing. Okay. So try to understand promotion or pricing. So if a company announces a price discount, as I mentioned, see, even for agricultural equipments like planters and harvesters, the demand will be high during the cultivation time. Generally, it will be between May, June, in India. So if a company announces a price discount or a price offer during the month of March and April on planters and harvesters, so some part of the demand from May to June or peak period will shift to off-peak period. So it will become during the peak period, the company will be able to handle the demand comfortably. So that is how a company tries to manage its demand okay, by way of price discounts and promotions, basically by way of shifting some percentage of the demand during the peak period to non-peak period. Okay, so even in US, Amazon, for example, in US, the main season for Walmart stores is December, the month of December, Christmas season. So the demand will be highest for Amazon, okay, during the month of December for Amazon. So in order to shift some percentage of the demand from December to November, Amazon gives great discounts to customers, okay, and it also gives free deliveries on certain, okay, orders, so that some percentage of the demand from December can be shifted to November and the company can handle the increase in demand in December comfortably. Second, timing of the promotion and the price changes is important. So generally, if during the off-peak period, if a company announces promotions or price discounts, okay, it shifts some of the demand from peak period to non-peak period. So this way, it helps, okay, enable a company to make use of its production capacity. And also the company will be able to handle the demand during season effectively. And this demand increases, okay, can result from a combination of three factors. So one is market growth, okay? So market growth is, let us say, if you remember Apple iPhone, okay, it has slashed the prices drastically on its 5 model, Apple iPhone 5. And Apple iPhone 6, okay, so around 20,000 to 25,000, okay, the price of Apple iPhone S and iPhone 6. So what happens in this case is those customers who wanted to buy, okay, other brands like, let us say, Samsung, okay, in the price range of 20,000 to 30,000, these customer will switch to Apple iPhone as the brand is quite popular. So certain segment of the market entirely switches to Apple iPhone. So this market growth, okay, the sales will increase, not only the sale for iPhone 5 and 6 models increase, but also the market size for iPhone 5 and iPhone 6 as well increases. So there is increase in sales as well as there is increase in the total demand for Apple iPhone 5 and iPhone 6. So we call it market growth. So in this case, the company can consider increasing production capacity. The second factor is stealing market share. Say for example, okay, you go to buy, okay, perfume, okay, and your favorite brand of perfume is 200 rupees and your competitor's brand has announced a 1+1 offer, buy one, get one free. It means almost 50% off. So that point in time you buy the competitor brand, you may buy the competitor brand. So the competing brand will experience increase in sales. Okay, but the market size remains the same because next month the customer or you are going to buy your favorite brand of perfume once again. Forward buying. So if you remember the examples of planters and harvesters, what I gave, okay, or the example of Amazon, okay, trying to shift the some percentage of the demand during December to November. So we call it forward buying. Enable the customer to buy well ahead of his purchasing time. So the sales as well as the market size remains the same because the customer who wanted to buy in December, okay, because of the good promotion offer, he has purchased during the month of November. So the same customer is again not going to buy, or the same set of customers are not going to buy again in December for Christmas. They already purchased it during November. Okay, so that is exactly what we meant by forward buying. So this is how, due to these three factors, demand increases. It is required for a company to know to effectively manage demand. Okay, so now 1:45 is left. So I'm going to unmute you all. You can ask questions, and if any question remains unanswered, you can please call me immediately and clarify your doubts. Okay, any questions from your end? Okay, those students who don't have a question, Kindly mute your audio. Okay, so I did not hear any question from students, but there are a lot of disturbance. That is why I have muted you all again. But remember that you can always ask me question by way of calling back. And I am sharing all the resources now only in one place. That is your Supply Chain Management Google Classroom. So keep visiting and download the resources and study for the examinations. And also from next week, for next 2 weeks, I have prepared a new timetable. So as per the students' request, the classes have been shifted to morning. So please check the new timetable which is sent in WhatsApp. So thank you one and all for your active participation, and see you on Tuesday. Please remember. And the Salesforce management students, please stay back in 10 minutes. Within 10 minutes, I'm going to start the class.